Hi, let us understand how to use the configuration file and its purpose. Till now we were starting the HashiCorp Vault server in the developer mode, so automatically it's going to get started in the unsealed state and we were not forced to do any special operation to start working with the secret engine. And in production scenario, there are a lot more configurations and the information needs to be provided to the server before getting started. And all that will be provided using the configuration file. And configuration file can be written in either of these two formats, that is HCL, HashiCorp Configuration Language, or JSON. HCL is very easy to understand and all the stack within HashiCorp will be using this HCL. We will have a quick overview on how this HCL can be written and how the data can be represented. So once the configuration file is made, I can provide that as an input while starting the server, that is within the command vault server dash config and then the location of the file. The configuration file should have permissions for the user who is starting the server. And it can be stored in any specific location. And generally in production, it will be stored in the location /etc/vault.d/vault.hcl. HCL is the extension. Any folder.d, that's the general representation that it's going to hold the configuration files. The major content of the configuration file will be two components, that is parameters and stanza. Parameter is nothing but it's going to have key and a value corresponding to it. Stanza is a collection of parameters and it is like a block. We will see a detailed example on how to write a stanza and what are all stanzas and parameter allowed within the configuration file. When it comes to the configuration file, it will be having information like the storage backend, what port it's going to listen to, whether it is going to use any TLS certificate, if yes, where it is located, and what type of seal to use, the cluster name, log level, what information, and where it should get logged, the configuration for the UI, Sentinel, service registration, that is where it should get registered as a service, telemetry on what information and where it should get stored, and the other details about the cluster. We will be having detailed discussion about each and every part of this. And to get started quickly, we will be doing a configuration file with the storage backend and listener. And configuration file will not have information about the secret engine, authentication methods, audit devices, encryption details, policies, users, groups, access control list, plugins, recovery, and resource quotas. All this will be done once the vault is started. This will not be provided as an input through the configuration file. To see through an example, this is how a sample configuration file looks like. Here I do have a simple example for the configuration file. Here I do have two stanzas, that is storage stanza and the listener stanza. And next to that, I do have three parameters, API address, cluster address, and the UI parameter. Within the stanza, depending on the type of stanza, I will be having n number of parameters. Let's have a quick overview on the HCL language that should give us more clarity on how to write stanza and the parameter. For the comment within the HCL, it will be starting with hash or double slash. And if I have multiple line comment, I can use the comment starting as slash star and the comment will be closed with star slash. And stanza or block, it's going to have collection of key value pairs and all the string within the stanza will be wrapped within the double quotes and it can have n number of primitive types like strings, number, boolean and all will be wrapped with double quotes. And if it is a list, I can have collection of primitive types and that will be enclosed with the square bracket. If I have multiple line string, I can have the EOF starting and closing and provide the multiple line strings. Sometimes I may need to provide the input like certificates that's going to be available in multiple line string and that will be provided using this particular input format. And I can have collections like maps and that will be enclosed within the flower bracket and all the keys and values will be separated with the colon and keys and values will be put within double quotes. These are all some of the important things to be taken care of within the HCL, and there are a lot more configurations can be done within HCL, but considering the configuration file of HashiCorp Vault, this should be sufficient enough. So within the HashiCorp configuration language, I can represent the block as what type of block it is, and I can add n number of labels to it. Following the label, I will be having a flower bracket, and I can have collection of arguments, that is identifier and expression. So blocks are nothing but that's like a container that's going to have collection of key value pairs, and I can have 0 to n number of labels. And arguments, after evaluating the expression, that will get assigned to this particular identifier. Depending on the block type, I can have n number of identifiers. So what stanza I am going to add to the configuration file, and what are all the identifier I can provide or the arguments I can provide, that will be provided within the configuration file. Say for example, within documentation, configuration, storage, I do have the details about various storage information I can provide. Let's take an example of file system. It's going to have the stanza something like this, the name of the storage and a label, and it can accept a parameter as path, that is path equal to and the value in string. Let's take another example of AWS S3. That's going to take three parameters: access key, secret key and bucket. This is how we can provide various parameters to the stanza. Within configuration file, these are all the configuration values I can provide. Say for example, storage, I need to provide a storage backend type as the value. So that's going to be a stanza. So I can provide any of the storage type, and depending on what storage type I'm going to use, I need to provide the configuration. If I want to use Cassandra, I can provide these values like host, consistency and the protocol version. The similar way, I can provide the configuration for HA storage, listener, seal, cluster name, cache size, disable cache, disable mlock, plugin directory, telemetry, and a lot more. We will be having detailed discussion about each and every configuration, what can be provided and how that needs to be configured. To get started with, I'm going to use a file type storage where I will be providing a folder location, and that will be used to store the data. Till now, we were using the developer mode for the HashiCorp Vault. So whenever I'm restarting the server, whatever the secrets that we were adding into the vault, that we're getting erased. Once we add the storage, so all the data will get stored within the storage. And that's where another question going to come into picture: how I am going to keep that particular storage safe so that no one else can access the storage and retrieve the secrets. For that, we are going to first configure the storage and start the server in production-like scenario, that is not a developer mode, and how to use the options like initializing the vault, unsealing the vault, and we will learn about sealing, unsealing, initializing, and a lot more. So to get started with, we will be using a configuration file, and we will do the configuration for the storage and start the vault server. So in a quick summary, we learned about what is a configuration file and its purpose, and how to do the configuration of stanza and parameter.